We have to rescue two celebrity warriors from that Shredder's universe. And this is the key for getting in and out of that dimension. So we must protect it with our lives, or we will forever be stranded there. I think this is yours. We'll tell the Shredders that the idiot warriors went rogue or something. As far as I'm concerned, welcome to the Foot Clan.
Think about it. Bruce is not fit to be an elite foot soldier, and the Shredders are trying to eliminate the weak. We just need to do nothing, and in no time, we will progress in the clan. Maybe I will be able to take the new elite position.
Someday, we'll be together.
Wait, something doesn't add up. If Chet didn't deal with Baxter or the Krang, who did?
If you don't want me to do to you what I did to the Krang, you'd better start spilling your guts about the Foot's plans. Hey, that rhymed.
Yes! Finally! My new creations are ready! No! Get back! Don't get close to me! Get away! Get away! As you know, we are losing numbers, even before starting. And your names came up after your last successful trip to Earth 87. To get stronger, I need you to go to my Earth and retrieve a canister of ooze. I'm not sure where it is, but you will bring an ooze detector that shall help you find it. That's it. You don't even need to do the regular kidnapping and fighting. Don't waste my time doing that. Are we clear?
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Good. Now take the gateway, the detector, and leave for Earth 90.
Home sweet home.
All right, this time we all need to be in line with what we do next.
What do you mean, what do we do next? It's a simple mission.
What I mean is, they just lost Baxter, and we didn't have a successful mission on Earth 87. I'm pretty sure they want us to get the ooze to make more mutants, and we will be the experiments.
Oh. Shouldn't we ask Chet to make that decision for us?
Why me?
Well, you have several processors, right? Can't you run a few simulations to see which path has the best outcomes for us?
I do not follow. Why can't you make a decision?
Because you're the one with the very expensive processors.
Okay, I can see this going nowhere. You two can have your little conversation while searching. Let's separate and find the real thing, plus another one we can use as a decoy.
Why bother finding the real one? Let's just find a canister with some radioactive material that looks like it. Hopefully not too radioactive.
Okay, just stay alert on your communicators. If we cannot contact each other, we will leave this Earth on this spot in 3 hours.
Hi. Are you part of the Foot Clan?
I used to, man. I ran away from my home and my folks, you know?
It's all right. You don't need to tell your story.
And I thought the Foot was gonna be my new family, but nah. Shredder abandoned us.
Yeah, yeah. Listen, do you remember some ooze canisters?
Yeah, man. I lost some of my mates because of that.
On experiments?
Yeah, man. We were experimenting with it. We thought it was gonna give us the halogens.
Hallucinations?
That's rich people talk, man. Anyway, it was the opposite, man. I started halogening about them being three-eyed monsters instead.
Okay, okay. Just, can you tell me where to find some?
Why? What's in it for me?
I can take you back to the Foot. Or pizza.
Done!
Great. Where can I find it?
I'll take you to it. It's in the junkyard. Oh, hi! The garage sale is right over here.
Thanks! I thought I was going in the right direction.
Feel free to ask. Some of these objects have sentimental, irreplaceable value. But everything is negotiable.
Are you having trouble getting rid of these things?
Not to me, but my sons. It is hard to afford their pizza cravings, you know?
I hear ya. Say, what about that ooze canister? Is it the real thing?
It's the real canister. But I'm afraid it's not the real ooze. I'm not sure what's in it. But it was on a lead box. It must be radioactive. Glows in the dark. Great way to cheer up your kid's birthday party.
I will buy it. How much for it?
That would be $1,200.
What? It's basically nuclear junk.
I see. I feel you and I have connected spiritually. I will give you a friendly discount. How about $1,000?
I think I should just go to the nuclear plant. I could probably trade a canister for a meat lover's pizza.
Wait, wait! You are right. You are a very intelligent individual. Why don't we leave it at $500? Final price! That's a lot of pizzas my sons will not be able to have. But just to make you a happy customer, I am willing to...
$250.
Deal! It's just water with fluorescent dye.
So you run the different scenarios and see which ones would result in the desired outcome.
Then I should stop making decisions based on simple conditions.
Exactly. It's very important to make decisions based on gathered intelligence. We shouldn't act on impulses, you know.
I see your point now. I think I am ready to run scenarios and bet for the winner instead of simple conditions.
Perfect. Now, is that April O'Neil?
Hello, Miss O'Neill. Do you remember me?
You're busted, creep! We finally found
what?
You!
Quick, Chet! This is your chance! Run your simulations! Compare the outcomes! Make the winning decision!
Done.
This junkyard looks lit!
This is not a junkyard. This is a Christmas tree sale.
Yeah, this junkyard bankrupted because of broken capitalism, man.
Where did they take all the garbage to?
To another junkyard?
Never mind. I can see it is still here.
I don't think we should go in there, man. The whole Christmas thing can trigger one of my episodes.
What are you talking about?
Last time I fought the Turtles, they kept on singing 12 Days of Christmas. And it was a different version of it, you know? One of the lines like, and a pizza with pepperoni.
Well, you will only get that pizza if I am successful here.
And a pizza with pepperoni!
Ernie?
And a pizza with pepperoni!
Ernie, are you there?
And a pizza with pepperoni.
You are not Ernie. Good news! I found a fake canister. Is that the real ooze?
No.
Are you going behind my back again?
Hi, guys. Do you need any help?
Get lost, Flaming Carrot!
Okay.
I can't believe you didn't consider helping me. The Turtles had to save me! This is ridiculous!
I just did what you told me.
But I'm your friend!
I am your friend, too.
Aww?
Where are you taking me?
To the junkyard.
I thought we were friends.
I'm not getting rid of you, silly. The Foot Clan had a hideout there. We may be able to find empty canisters.
Is this a junkyard?
The pizza with pepperoni.
Huh. Must have changed owners.
I don't think you understand your position in the clan.
I don't think you understand the clan.
That's it! We will decide this with a fight! What?
Did Chet just leave us stranded on this earth?
Seems like it. He probably ran a simulation and made a decision.
Simulation?
You never pay attention to us.
I cannot blame him.
Now what is that supposed to mean?
The pizza with
pepper. You've got our attention.
Who are these guys?
I don't know, but listen. That time on Earth 87. Remember when you lost the gateway? How did you get it back?
I don't know. A guy with an orange glove came out of nowhere and gave it back to me.
Alright. It doesn't seem like he's helping us this time. Prepare, guys. This will be the battle of our lifetime. And we will win. or fall trying. Wake up, guys.
What? Where are we?
I don't know. I think it's Earth 84.
What is the last thing you remember?
I remember you saying that we were gonna fight the guys in blue spandex.
One of them had black spandex.
Like it changes anything.
I think they put us to sleep somehow.
Oh. Hi, guys.
You treacherous fiend!
Whoa. Let Chet explain his decision.
You were correct. The Shredder wanted to use the ooze right away, which is why it was a good call to come back alone, as I am the only one who could not be mutated.
Who was mutated?
To local foot ninja.
Was it successful?
Hug me. Hug me. Hug me.
No!
Hug me.
Get back! Don't get any closer to me!
I see.
So, did you rescue us?
No, I had to give the gateway back.
Then what happened?
I'm under the impression that the guys in spandex actually took us back here.
Why would they do that? Do you think they're related to the guy with the orange gloves?
How would I know?
And a pizza with pepperoni.